Hi, this is Susan Haynes, and it's September 2011. What I'd like to do is go through a couple examples on this paper, which is currently located right here at emunix.emich.edu/tildehaynes/paper/recursion/recursion.html. I just want to go through a couple examples to show you how to trace recursion, which is the first step that I take in order to understand recursion. So we'll start with the classic Fibonacci series of numbers, and the Fibonacci series of numbers, each Fibonacci number, f of n, is computed by adding together f of n minus 1 and f of n minus 2, and if n equals 0 or n equals 1, then I want to return 1. So here is the code, a C-like code, that will implement this recursive function, and we see here I'm defining the function fib based on the parameter n. N is the Fibonacci number we wish to compute. And in order to compute the Fibonacci number of n, I need to have the recursive calls right here. So I actually have two recursive calls, as in the definition, Fibonacci of n minus 1 and Fibonacci of n minus 2. And the subscripts right here are just to identify for the human tracer so that you can see follow the activation tree and not get confused which call this one or this one that you are working on. The base case is implemented right here. If n equals 0 or n equals 1, return 1. So when we think about recursion, you will be taking your problem right there and dividing it into smaller problems that you solve using the same operation on it. So here's our problem n. I need to compute the Fibonacci of n. I should say this is the problem set size. And in order to find that, I'm going to do it on a smaller problem set size, n minus 1, but I'll be doing exactly the same thing on this. So that's the reduced sets are n minus 1 and n minus 2. Often there will be a construction or some kind of operation that you'll do with the solution of the problem on the simplified set. And in this case, I'm doing something by adding these two things together. Okay, so to trace through this problem for fib 3, I'm building the activation tree, which shows the sequence of calls and returns on the runtime stack. So there'll be two things that I need to keep track of. This thing right here will be keeping track of the data of the environment at a particular moment of execution. And this thing right here is keeping track of the executable portion. So I start executing this. I'm entering Fibonacci with n equals 3. So I push the stack frame on for n equals 3 right here. I test n equals 0. This right here is the only thing that I have available to look at. These two will not show up until later on in the execution. So n is clearly 3, so I fail these two tests. So I need to compute Fibonacci of n minus 1. So that means I'm going to call or push on the stack frame n minus 1. 3 minus 1 is 2. So I'm calling Fibonacci 2, and there's the stack frame to show that. Now I've labeled the stack frame with fib 1 so that I know when I return from this stack frame and go back up to my parent, I'm returning from a call to fib 1. Okay, so I'm calling fib 1 with the parameter 2 right here, and in order to execute that, I start executing in the function fib n equals 2. I have n equals 0 fails, n equals 1 fails, so I need to make a call to fib of 2 minus 1 gives me 1. So that's this call right here. It's a call to fib 1. Okay, so this is my current environment. I start executing. I have fib 1, n equals 0 fails, n equals 1 succeeds, so I return 1. And for convenience, I put the return value, I just put it here so I can keep track of it in this little second box. So this is my return value. When I return, it's popping this thing. This gets popped off the stack right here, and this 1 gets returned up to the previous environment. So I'm back in this environment right here, and in this environment I have a return value of 1, and the return value of 1 comes from a call to fib 1. So I'm returning from here. This thing right here has a value of 1 right here. Okay, but what environment am I in? I'm in this environment right here where n equals 2. Okay, so I have here the value 1. I need to compute this thing right here, fib of n minus 2. I know n is 2 from this thing right here, so fib of 0. So that's my call, right to here. Okay, so n equals 0 right here. This test succeeds, so I return the 1. There we go, there's my return value. So this thing right here gets popped off the runtime stack, and I'm returning up to this environment with the value of 1, returning from a call to fib2. So this has a value of 1. I've already computed that this has a value of 1. I'm sitting here in this environment right here. I add 1 plus 1 gives me 2, and that is my return value. So there's my 2. So this is popped off the stack, and I return up here to Fibonacci, where in my current environment n has the value 3, and I've returned with the return value of 2 from a call to fib1. So this thing right here is returning with a call with the value 2. So we pop this off the stack. I have a return value of 2 right here. I need to compute this. So I make the call. N minus 2 is 1, so here's my 1. N is 0, nope. N is 1, yes, so I return a 1. So that's this one right here, will be returned. And when I return, this is popped off the stack. I move back up to my parent. This thing right here then has the value 1 from here. I've already computed the value 2 for this from here. I add those two things together, that gives me 3. That will be my return value right there. So when I finally return from this invocation, I have a return value of 3.